To learn the good, the bad, and the reality of the off-grid lifestyle, click subscribe so you don't miss anything. Hit the bell notification. Carolyn and I traveled the country from east to west, south to north, for 3 years. Coming back to Missouri, I realized that there's no place prettier. I mean, you know, maybe it's home, you know, it's where I grew up. It's a beautiful spring day. It's supposed to be partly cloudy, but I would say it's mostly sunny. The leaves are turning green, and it's mushroom season here in Missouri, and it's a big thing. A lot of people do it. My parents were big mushroom hunters, both of them. They both love it. My mother's parents were big mushroom hunters. And so you would think that I would be really good at mushroom hunting. But I've come out for the last 2 days. I see everybody posting on Facebook, mushrooms. I can't find any. Of course, I only have an acre and a half, so it's not like I got a long spread that I can go through. But there's something here, right here, that makes me feel like there should be mushrooms just popping up right here. Now, of course, the squirrels could have beaten me to it. I've seen a lot of scratching in the ground. But I don't know. For some reason, I remember somebody, I don't know, mom, dad, grandparents, telling me that if you see these things right here popping up, that there should be mushrooms around. Well, I've got, I don't know, maybe a 10, 15 foot diameter here of these little things popping up. But of course, I see no mushrooms. I am the worst mushroom hunter. I don't think I've ever found one. Now, I love them. They're great being sauteed in butter. I'll keep trying. And the thing is why not? This is the great thing about living off-grid. And even on a small piece of property, I can come out here and I just enjoy being out here. I'm going to come out here as much as I can. Now, of course, as summer moves along, you know, those copperhead snakes, got to be careful of the copperhead snakes. And being down here by the creek, there may be water moccasins also. So, yeah, I got to be careful of those. And then you got ticks and poison ivy. Now, I'm not too allergic to poison ivy. And I don't even know if allergic is the right word. I don't get it really bad. I've got two spots on my arm right now. Carolyn, on the other hand, is just covered in poison ivy. We've got hydrocortisone cream. She's taking Benadryl, which seems to help. But man, I feel so bad for her. And the thing is I don't know where she's getting it from. She's not coming out here in the woods. So that means up there by the trailer, she's up there cleaning. There must be some poison ivy. I told her to make sure that she wears gloves and don't touch your face. The other thing is she's been burning a lot of material. And I've heard, I don't know how true it is, that burning poison ivy can actually get it up in your face and she can get it that way. So I feel so bad for her. She's pretty tough though. She doesn't let it bother her. So, like I said, being sunny today, I mean, we're making that magical electricity. Making electricity out of thin light. Thin air, thin light. I don't know. Maybe that wasn't funny. And I tell you, I am so proud of my electrical system. Now, I want to be clear on something. I don't feel like I provide advice on this channel. The only advice I try to provide is do your research and try it out. Practice. And if you don't like it, try something else. There's a million ways to do something. You got to do what's best for you. If I've ever suggested that you should get my solar panels, I have said that I like the brand name, but that's just my recommendation. I have said I like Berkey. That's a recommendation. But as far as advising you, no. Like the water filtration, the Berkey, there's a lot of other brands out there. Reverse osmosis actually is the best type of water filtration you can have. It cleans the water. It doesn't filter the water. It actually cleans the water. The problem with the reverse osmosis, in my opinion, is it wastes a lot of water. You actually have wastewater. It comes right out of a tube and down the drain. So you're wasting that water. And I don't want to waste water. So the Berkey does fine for us. Someone has suggested that you should not take my advice on electric. I don't feel like I've given you any advice on electric. I feel like I've told you what I've done and I told you that why I did it, which is, in my opinion, this is very cost effective. So what I have is a 12 volt system. Each of these eight panels is 100 watts. So I have 800 watts of 12 volt electric. I would imagine that anybody that knows anything about solar panels are gonna say, no, you want 24 volts. And I have said that in other videos. The problem is I don't understand it as well. I know how this works, so no matter what I do, I can make it work. I don't understand 24 volts as well. I can do it, but I didn't want to have to spend all the money, trial and error, and this mistake and that mistake. So I went with something I knew to save money. This is also very cost effective, in my opinion. Each one of these solar panels costs $75. And it is producing all the electric that we use. It's actually making more electric than what we use. So I can't complain about it at all. I'm very happy with it. And if somebody said today, why don't you switch over to 24 volt? I'll set you up. I would probably say, nah, I'm fine with what I got. All right, here's the thing. I have used this same exact system forever. When I lived in a house, I don't know, back in 07, 08, I had four solar panels. There were 12 volt solar panels. I had several 12 volt batteries, lead acid batteries, the cheap ones at Walmart. I had an inverter, and I ran a lot of stuff in that house off that system. And it wasn't a lot of electric. We ran most of the lights in the house. Now back then you couldn't even buy LED lights very inexpensively. Today, that would have been a great system. During power outages, I could run the refrigerator. That's where I learned how to do solar and 12 volts. Well, then we went into the nomadic lifestyle. And I knew that I was not going to want solar in the nomadic lifestyle. I knew it from the day I started because I had them. And they took a lot of work that I didn't think I would have in the nomadic lifestyle. That being said, everything else I did was exactly the same in my electrical setup. And the only difference was my charging source was the generator, not the solar panels. So I still had the lead acid battery that you buy from Walmart I just bought a second one for $89. The lead acid batteries, the first one I bought, burned up in the first fire. That one lasted a year. So the second one that I bought, we've had for 2 years now. Oh, yeah, 2 years. And it still works like new. I just added another battery to it because now we're on solar. And I wanted to make sure I had enough battery to get me through cloudy days, to get me out maybe 4 or 5 hours on a cloudy day. The thing about lead acid batteries over lithium batteries is you got to maintain them. And so every now and then, you got to charge it with a battery charger. One of those computer battery chargers that you can buy at Walmart. And you do a little trickle charge. You let it charge for 4 or 5 hours. Sometimes you'll do what's called a rejuvenate cycle. And that battery charger you buy at Walmart has a rejuvenate cycle. And then I just take an inverter, a 750 watt modified sine wave inverter, and I run everything I need off of it. So we have an air conditioner. And that we just put in, and it's working great. I mean, absolutely fantastic. Now, I can't run an air conditioner all day and all night. What I do is during the hottest part of the day, so about noon, I kick on the air conditioner. We run it, I don't know, until about 4 or 5 o'clock. Now, the hotter the day gets, you know, in July and August, we may have to run it a little longer from noon to say 6. But that's okay because the sun will be in the sky longer. Right now, sunset's around 7:30. But in July, on July 4th, sunset's at 8:30. So I'll be able to run it a little bit longer and still get plenty of power from the solar panels. I have the refrigerator. Now I can also run most of my power tools off the solar. It's working great. And the only thing I can't run right now is because my inverter isn't big enough. I need to get a bigger inverter. Is a little skill saw. When I get a bigger inverter, I'll also be able to run my well pump off of it. The disadvantage to 12 volt system over a 24 volt system, and I've said this in a lot of videos now, is in order to run your 12 volts over a length of, you got to have really big copper wire. Like I said in a previous video, in order to even run my DC electric from there up to the trailer here, it's 300 feet, I don't think I could get enough copper wire. It would be very expensive. That's the disadvantage. How many amps are you having to carry through a wire? And so it's Ohm's law. If anybody's ever heard of Ohm's law, you will get resistance through your wire. So since this is 12 volt, I got to have more amps to get 100 watts. Whereas I had 24 volts, I would need less amps. Volts times amps equals watt. So like I said, what's trying to say is there's so many options available when it comes to electric that no, you shouldn't take my advice. My advice is though, do your research and give it a try. Thanks for watching.